हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ संदीप सिया भंग, लेक्चरर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, CSMSS कॉलेज ऑफ पॉलिटेक्निक, कंचनवाड़ी, औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी आर लर्न अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू मशीन डिज़ाइन। सो बेसिकली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज मशीन डिज़ाइन? मशीन डिज़ाइन इज नथिंग बट द creation of new and better machine along with updating existing ones. It means that if you are having some idea in your mind, so you can design or create a new machine, otherwise you are updating existing one machines. It means that those machines are available in the field of mechanical engineering and these has a need of change, so these machines are change or update with the design basics. It means that or it is invented or modified by creating an ideas in a design engineer's mind. This idea can be transformed in terms of dimensions and drawing. It is also nothing but the design. First of all, we have to consider the general design procedure of or in machine design. The general design procedure is like that. First of all, the first step is need, second is synthesis of mechanism, third is analysis of forces, fourth is material selection, fifth is design of elements, sixth is modification, seventh is detailed drawing, and last is production. Let us see one by one. The need is nothing but the design engineer should kept idea in her mind and making a survey or doing a survey and making a statement of a problem and it place into the onto the paper. This is a or what is the need of a of the market. That is nothing but the need, recognition of need. Second point or second step of the machine design is synthesis of mechanism. In synthesis of mechanism, the design engineer should think that the which kind of machine or which kind of motion or which kind of kinematics is applicable for the designed product. It means that the design engineer should design or is to be designed the product which required which kind of parts, which kind of machines, which kind of motions, and so many things. So this part is considered in the synthesis of mechanism. The third one is the analysis of forces. In analysis of forces, the design engineer should calculate or find out the which types of forces and stresses or which kinds of loads are to be acting on the mechanical member which is to be designed. After that, the fourth one is the material selection. It is the most important criteria for the design engineers who select the appropriate material for the designing component so that it can achieve good and desirable properties. In design of element, the design engineer should calculate the which kind of stress or which type of stress is to be developed in the mechanical member so that he is finding out the magnitude of the stress. Modification. The modification is whatever mistake is done by the design engineer which is modified by the senior design engineer at this stage. This is nothing but the modification. After that, detailed drawing. Whatever is to be designed by the design engineer, it is placed in terms of the detailed drawing, and this detailed drawing is forwarded to the production department so that the production process will be start. This is the general design procedure which follows in the industry or company. The general considerations in design are the types of loads and stresses caused by the loads. It means that the loads and stresses caused by the loads. Second, mechanism. In mechanism, motion of the parts or kinematics of machine. Third, selection of material. Fourth, convenient and economical features. Fourth, use of standard part. Sixth, safety of operation. Seventh, workshop facility. Eighth, number of machines to be manufactured. Ninth, cost of construction and assembly. 10th, frictional resistance and lubrication. All these are the general considerations in a design. It means that whenever we are designing a component, the design engineer should thinking about these facility are available in the in-house or not. Some are applicable on the member or not, such that types of load and stresses caused by the loads or mechanism, selection of material, etc., etc. And use of standard parts allows to minimize the cost of the product. Safety of operation means the machines or the workshop. In the workshop, the operation safety is available or not. And also, number of machines to be manufactured. Number of machines to be manufactured means if we are producing a new component and we are having only 10 number of machines to be manufactured. Instead of that, we are having 1 lakh machines to be manufactured. So which we are choosing? Obviously we are choosing 1 lakh product instead of 10 machines. Understand? Same, the cost of construction and assembly. The cost of construction and assembly is also economical in favor of company. Also, frictional resistances and lubrications. If the design is complicated or requires the frictional resistances and lubrications, so we are think it early whenever we are designing the component, the lubrications are to be present in our store or in own house or workshop. So the types of load is a more important criteria for the design engineers or for designing any kind of machine. The types of load is more important. So The design engineer should calculate the which type of load or understand the which kind of load is to be acting on the mechanical member, so that according to that load the stress is to be induced in the material and that kind of failure is to be observed. So first type of load is dead or steady load. The name indicates that it is a dead or steady. It means that it does not change in magnitude, direction or point of application with respect to time. It is called as dead or steady load. Example, load acting on a column or strut. Second type of load is the variable or fluctuating load. The name indicates that it is a load is variable or fluctuating. It means that the magnitude or direction of the load is fluctuating or variable. It means that it varies in magnitude, direction or point of application with respect to time. It is also called as fatigue load. It will be reverse, repeated or completely reverse. Example, force in a IC engine valve spring. Third type of load is impact load. It is suddenly applied with initial velocity. It is a suddenly applied load, but it has a initial velocity. It means that our example is blow of hammer. We are blowing a hammer with some velocity on a chisel. It is the simplest example of impact load. Fourth one is the shock load. Shock load is nothing but the it is applied or removed suddenly. Example is leaf spring of an automobile. So this is the introduction part of the machine design. We will be continued after this lecture with more content.